Bonjour, je m'appelle Dr. Tin et bienvenue à French 13 11, chapitre 5, leçon 10. Aujourd'hui, nous allons étudier les expressions de quantité, les expressions de quantité. J'espère que tout le monde va très bien. Hello, my name is Dr. Tin and welcome to French 13 11, Chapter 5, Lesson 10. Today we are going to study expressions of quantity in French, expressions of quantity in French. I hope everybody is doing very well. Okay, allez-y. Page 144, 146. Les expressions de quantité. Les expressions de quantité. Expressions of quantity. Expressions of quantity. Ça va? So we are going to learn how to say quite a few vegetables. Not much sugar. Hardly any sugar, or a little bit of garlic, right? So, pay attention here. Ça va? Très bien. So, les expressions de quantité. All right, we have learned that the partitive article, right, will also have this preposition there. De, which means of plus the product you're talking of, right? Here too, with the expressions of quantity, we also have de. But whereas the partitive article will use the definite article, le, L-E, or L apostrophe, or la, or the plural, les. With these expressions of quantity, you just have to add the noun. Just add the noun without any articles in front of the nouns. So, de will be followed by the noun, the product you're talking about, right? Since we are dealing with food items, the food items you are talking about will follow directly without any articles in front of them. Okay, so these expressions will use a product, right? A noun, right? Without any articles in front of them. Okay, so assez de, répétez, assez de, beaucoup de, pas mal de, pas mal de. Okay, pas mal de means quite a few. Okay? Peu de. Not much, hardly any. Okay? Now here you have un peu de. Un peu de. A little bit of. A little bit of. Here, peu de. Peu de. Hardly any. Not much, right? And then, pas mal de means quite a few. Like you want to say, quite a few vegetables, right? There are quite a few vegetables in the soup, right? Il y a pas mal de légumes dans la soupe. Okay. So, de. Now, trop de means too much or too many, depending on the noun. If the noun is plural, right, then you will say too many, right? If the noun is a mass noun, uncountable noun, then you will say too much, right? Très bien. So, trop de, un verre de, a glass of, okay? Une bouteille de, a bottle of. Une assiette de, a plate of. Une tasse de, a cup of. A little mark, right? Of. Okay, so, assez de. Enough, right? I have enough books, right? So, you put your books here, or you want to say, I have enough meat, right? You say, assez de, and then you put your meat here, which is meat in French will be viande. So, you put your viande here. Without any article in front of viande. Assez de viande. J'ai assez de viande. I have enough meat. Okay? Now, il y a beaucoup de. There is a lot of. Okay? Il y a beaucoup de. Vin. There is a lot of wine, right? Il y a beaucoup de vin. Okay? Now, j'ai pas mal de. I have quite a few, right? Il y a pas mal de. There's quite a few. Now, vegetables, right? Quite a few vegetables. Il y a pas mal de légumes. Quite a few vegetables, right? Dans la soupe, in the soup. Okay, peu de. Not much. Hardly any, right? So you want to say there is hardly any fish in the soup. There is hardly any sugar in the coffee, right? Then you put coffee here or fish here. Peu de sel. Il y a peu de sel. Salt, right? Il y a peu de sel dans la soupe. Right? There is hardly any salt. qui peut de Harley any not much salt. Alright, il y a peu de sel dans la soupe. Un peu de. A little bit. Right? A little bit. So you say, I have a little bit of garlic. Right? In the soup. So garlic is, right? Aïe. Right? But because you have voyelle, vous laissez tomber la première voyelle et vous mettez l'apostrophe. Because there was this day, right? The E is dropped in front of this other vowel in front of it, and then we put our apostrophe. Okay? Un peu d'ail. Okay? Un peu d'ail, a little bit of garlic. Okay, here, if you want to say there is too much, right? Trop de oil. Si oil is huile, right? So silent H, right? And this vowel meaning you drop there. First vowel and put your apostrophe, the same thing you did with un peu d'ail. So here you see trop d'huile, right? H is silent, right? So you see that this is followed by a vowel, right? And then there is a vowel, two vowels meet. You drop the first one, you put your apostrophe. Ça va? Très bien. Un verre de. Let's do the same thing with un verre de. If you want to say a glass of water, right? Water is eau. So, voyelle. Vous laissez tomber la première voyelle. You drop your first vowel. Et vous mettez l'apostrophe. And then you put your apostrophe there. Okay. So remember where you do a little bit of change. Where you see the two vowels meeting. You drop the first one and then you put your apostrophe. Une bouteille, a bottle of vin. We don't do anything here because V est une consonne, is a consonant, right? So, see that? This is a vowel, this is a consonant. You don't do anything. Okay, une assiette de, let's say rice. A plate of rice, right? A bowl of rice, right? A plate, a full plate of rice. Riz, right? The Z, right? Z. Okay, une assiette de riz. Okay, une tasse de café. A cup of coffee. Ça va? So here, de will not be combined with any article. It will stand alone, right? When de comes into contact, however, with another vowel or a silent H, right? You will drop the E. That comes after de. Right, the E that comes after the D, and then you put your apostrophe here. When the E that comes in front of de comes into contact with a noun beginning with a vowel or a silent H, voyelle, and then H, Vous laissez tomber un, you drop your E, et vous mettez l'apostrophe. You drop your E, and you put your apostrophe there. Other than that, right, you don't make any changes. All you do is to add whatever now you want to add to these expressions of quantity. Ça va bien? Ça va? Au revoir et à bientôt.